Hello friends, today we are discussing with the topic streamer mechanism or canal mechanism of breakdown. So how that streamer mechanism or canal mechanism will occur, we will see with the help of one diagram. So how streamer mechanism will happen with the help of this diagram, we will see. This diagram represents the field redistribution due to space charges. So with the help of one diagram, we will see how streamer mechanism or canal mechanism will be happen. So there will be a two electrode, which is anode and cathode. So anode will be designed as plus sign and cathode will be represented as minus side. So when collision occur, there will be a one positively ion and one negative ion. So that field redistribution due to space charges will occur in this diagram, we will see. So that minus sign means positive sign or positive ion will attract towards the negative ion, and positive ion here that created due to the collision process will attract it toward the cathode, and this is the field redistribution due to space charges. So when streamer mechanism or streamer spark will happen, we know that the charges in between electrode separated by distance d increases by factor e raised to alpha d. Here e raised to alpha d means a streamer mechanism between electrodes is uniform. Means when streamer mechanism will happen, as we increase e raised to alpha d, the distance in between e raised to alpha d, that will increase the streamer mechanism. This is valid only if we assume that the field E naught is equal to V by d is not affected by space charges, means there is no any space charges of electrons and positive ions. Rather, has observed that if the charge concentration is higher than 10 raised to 6, means the charge in that vacuum is higher than 10 raised to 6 but lower than 10 raised to 8, there will be the growth of an avalanche is weakened, means the breakdown will happen in weaker way, that is dN by dx is raised to e raised to alpha d. dN by dx less than e raised to alpha d means when charge concentration is higher than 10 raised to 6 and lower than 10 raised to 8, means lies between 10 raised to 6 to 10 raised to 8, it will be the breakdown phenomenon will be weakened. Whenever the concentration exceeds 10 raised to 8, the avalanche current is followed by step rise in current and breakdown of gap takes place. Means when the avalanche breakdown reaches 10 raised to 8, the rise in current and breakdown will happen in more way. The weakening of avalanche at lower concentration and rapid growth of avalanche at higher concentration have been attributed to the modification of electric field E naught due to space charge field. Means that breakdown will be happen due to high voltage source or low voltage source. And its figures shows that the electric field around an avalanche as it progresses along the gap and resultant field, that is the superposition of the space charge field and original field E naught, since the electrons have higher mobility, means the electrons in that gas vacuum or vacuum chamber will have mobile at initial state, mobility state. The space charge at head of avalanche is considered to be negative, means that charges are in that gas chamber will be negative and is assumed to be concentrated with a spherical volume. So volume of that gas molecule will be a spherical in shape. It can be seen from figure that the field at the head of avalanche is strengthened. At the initial state it is strengthened. The field between two assumed charge centers, that is, the electrons and positive ions, is decrease as the field due to charge center opposes the main field. Means the electrons and positive ions are decreased as field due to charge centers opposes the main field, E naught, means voltage V. And again, the field between positive space charge center and cathode is strengthened as the space charge field aids to the main field E naught in this region. Means as the main field in this region is increased, the space charge, means cathode or towards the cathode, is strengthened. And it has been observed that if the charge carrier number exceeds 10^6, the field distortion becomes noticeable. Means in the gap between 10^6 and 10^8, the breakdown will occur if gas attains a 10^8 value. So if the distortion of field is of 1%, it would be lead to a doubling of avalanche means breakdown will occur in more way. But as the field distortion is only near the head of avalanche, it does not have a significance on the discharge phenomenon. Means avalanche happen in between the distance between anode and cathode at the mid, the discharges phenomenon will be small in the case. So however, if the charge carrier exceeds 10^8 means the value of the gas chamber or the amplification of the gas raised to 10^8, the space charge field becomes almost the same magnitude as we have produces or as we have provided high voltage. The space charge field becomes almost same magnitude as the main field E naught, and hence lead to initiation of streamer. Means the streamer means the ultraviolet light that will keep on a cathode ray, that will be initiated as main field E naught, and hence it will lead to the initiation of streamer. Further moving to this topic, we will see the post breakdown phenomenon and its application. What is arc glow? For that purpose, we have drawn one diagram, that is applied voltage in y axis and applied current, that is post breakdown phenomenon, applied current in x axis. So there will be current will be increases, we will see in G to F region, in F to E region it will also increases, further it will be down in E to D region, further suddenly increases in D to C region, and it will increases from C to B, and further it is constant. So how that post breakdown will be occur, we will see. This diagram represents the DC voltage current characteristics of an electrical discharge with electrodes having no sharp point or edges. Means there is no sharp points in the gas chamber. So that time, this is the DC voltage current characteristics. So this is phenomenon which occurs after the actual breakdown, means post breakdown, means when two molecule are collide with each other, then it will happen the breakdown. So post breakdown phenomenon means the phenomenon when actual breakdown was happen. This phenomenon which occurs after actual breakdown has taken place and is technical importance. It is also having the technical importance. So it is happen in two way, in glow discharge and in arc discharge. So glow and arc discharges are the post breakdown phenomena, and there are many devices that operate over these regions. In Townsend's discharge, the current increases gradually as a function of applied voltage. Means as the initial part, when applied voltage gradually increases, the current will also increases, as we have seen in the figure. Further to this point B, only current increases and discharge change from Townsend type to glow type BC. Means in the last slide, we will see the discharge or when applied voltage will be increases, it will be from G to F. At G to F, it will suddenly increases. Then further increase in current results in a very small reduction in voltage across the gap CD corresponding to the normal glow region. means there will be a glow in a chamber in C2D region. The gap voltage again increases D2E when current is increased more, but eventually leads to considerable drop in applied voltage. Here, notice one thing, that here also will be the voltage drop due to some of the sparks. So the gap voltage between DE when the current is increased more, but eventually leads to considerable drop in voltage. This region of arc discharge, that EG region, is the arc discharge. As we have seen earlier glow discharge, same there will be a arc discharge, EG. The phenomenon that occur in region CG are the post breakdown phenomenon. So the post breakdown will happen in CG phenomenon, consisting glow discharge and arc discharge. So glow discharge represented by C2E phenomenon or C2E region, and arc discharge we will see in E2G region. So what is mean by glow discharge? A glow discharge is characterized by diffuse luminous glow. Means luminous glow means in coronal losses there will be a bluish luminous glow. The color of glow discharge depends on cathode material. What type of cathode material there will be used, that glow discharge will depends on cathode material. And gas used, what type of gas is used in chamber. The glow discharge covers the cathode partly, and the space between cathode and anode will have intermediate dark and bright regions. This is called as a normal glow. Means glow occur in the chamber between cathode anode at the immediate dark and bright region, and that is called as the nominal glow. If current in the nominal glow is increased such that the discharge occur the entire cathode surface, then it becomes abnormal glow. Means the glow will be more when the current in the normal glow is increased such that the discharge covers the entire cathode surface, that will be the abnormal glow, or glow increases. As glow discharge increases, in a glow discharge, the voltage drop between the electrodes is substantially constant. Means when glow discharge occur, the voltage drop between electrodes is substantially constant. Here one thing will be noticed, that voltage drop will be constant in glow discharge, and it will be ranging from 75 to 300 volt. Means glow discharge, we can say it is happen in 75 volt and 300 volt, or a current range of 1 milliamps and 100 milliamps depending on the type of gas, and it will be vary from nature of the gas or what type of gas it will occur. The properties of glow discharge are used in many practical applications, such as cold cathode gaseous voltage stabilized tubes, voltage regulation tubes, and VR tubes. So they are having some applications. They are used as cold cathode gaseous voltage stabilized tubes, then voltage regulation tubes and VR tubes for rectification as a relaxation oscillator and amplifier. So that glow discharge will be, or cold cathode gaseous voltage stabilized tubes are used for rectification purpose, relaxation oscillator purpose, and as a amplifier we can use. So we will further see what is mean by arc discharge. If the current in the gap is increased, if the current in the gap is increased to about 1 milliamps or 1 ampere or more, the voltage across the gap suddenly reduces to a few volts, 20 to 50 volt. Means as we increase the current above the 1 ampere in arc discharge, we will get the voltage as 20 to 50 volt. The discharge becomes very luminous and noisy. Here in arc discharge there will be a hissing noise, as in the corona discharge there will be a hissing noise and luminous glow. This phase is called as the arc discharge. So that noise and glow are called as the arc discharge. And the current density over the cathode region increases to very high values, that is 10 raised to 3 to 10 raised to 7 ampere per centimeter square. Means here the glow discharge, or the density of that discharge, will be in 10 raised to 3 and 10 raised to 7 ampere. Arcing is associated with high temperature ranging from 1000 degree Celsius to several thousand of degree Celsius. Means that type of arcing will happen at high temperature level also. So what is the post breakdown phenomenon we have seen in this video? Now we will see what is its application. Post breakdown application. The study of arcs is important, means that phenomenon, post breakdown phenomenon, is important in circuit breaker and other switch contacts. Arc will be happen in which circuit breaker are used and switch contacts will be used. So that type of in MCB, MCCB, so that type of switchgear equipment, there will be a arc that will be helpful for the electrical engineer to slow down the arc or arc discharge. It is a convenient high temperature, high intensity light source. It will be used as a convenient high intensity light source. Then it is used for welding and cutting of metals. Here in welding and cutting metals, there will be a glow arc. There will be a glow arc. So that type of post breakdown phenomenon we are used. Then it is light source in lamps such as carbon arc lamp. So in carbon arc lamp, the glow discharge will be more, and to get more glow discharge, we are using a post breakdown phenomenon. So this is about the post breakdown phenomenon. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda.